The 1st of July is a big day in Australia. Not only is it the start of a new month, but it's the start of a new financial year here in the land down under. And with a new year comes big changes, many of which will affect international students in Australia, and you might be one of them. Now, we know what you're probably thinking. What are these changes? How are they going to affect you moving forward? Is there anything that you need to be doing differently now that these changes are in effect? Well, you've got the questions and we've got the answers. In this video, we're going to be talking about the latest updates that you need to know all about, specifically the ones that have come into effect as of the 1st of July, 2023. From newly capped working hours to increased visa application costs, we're going to cover all of it. So without further ado, let's get started. First on the list is a new working hour cap for international students. As of July 1st, 2023, international students are only allowed to work up to 48 hours per fortnight, which is a 14-day period. This working hour cap applies only during study periods, which means that international students can still work unlimited hours during study breaks. Previously, international students were only able to work 40 hours per fortnight during study periods. However, as you might know from personal experience, these restrictions were relaxed and then removed entirely during the COVID-19 pandemic. This meant that international students were allowed to work unlimited hours during this time. Many people saw this as something of a win-win, because it meant that students could bolster their income and the government could cope with the labor shortages that the country was experiencing due to the pandemic. However, as the world is slowly but surely bouncing back post-pandemic, the government is now reinstating the rule, but at a higher cap per fortnight. Now, there is a very important exception to this rule that may apply to you, so it's very important to be aware of it. If you're an international student that's working in aged care, you'll still be allowed to work unlimited hours for the rest of the calendar year. So that is until the 31st of December, 2023. This is because Australia's aged care sector is still experiencing significant shortages. With Australia's aging population in mind, having enough workers in this industry is a top priority. Next, let's talk about the rise in Australia's national minimum wage. Now, even though the number of hours that you can work as an international student will be restricted, the amount that you get paid for those hours could be on the rise. Australia's minimum wage is increasing once again this year, which is awesome news for international students who are earning at this rate. In the 2022 to 2023 financial year, the minimum wage was $21.38 per hour, or $812.60 per 38-hour work week, and this is before tax. However, from July 1st, 2023, the minimum wage will rise to $23.23 per hour, or $882.80 per 38-hour work week. And again, this is all before tax. This change represents an increase of roughly 8.6% for national minimum wage earners. Now, if you're already based in Australia, you might be a little bit confused by this number, so allow us to explain. Many news outlets were reporting earlier this year, when it was first announced that the minimum wage would be increasing, that it would only be increasing by 5.75% this year. So where did we get this 8.6 figure? This is because the government is readjusting the minimum wage to align with a higher wage classification. So in Australia, there are basically different levels or classifications of pay, many of which are classed between C2 and C14, with C14 being the lowest level of pay. Although the national minimum wage used to align with the C14 rate, which was $21.38 per hour, it's now being bumped up to align with the C13 rate, which is $21.97 per hour. As of July 1st, 2023, it is this C13 rate that will get the boost of 5.75%, creating the new minimum wage of $23.23 per hour. Next, let's talk about the increase in visa application costs. Now, this next update may not necessarily affect you if you're an international student who's already based here in Australia, but it will affect you if you're still considering studying in Australia and have yet to apply for your student visa. Earlier this year, the federal government announced that the visa application costs, which are also known as VACs, for several visa subclasses would be increasing as of July 1st, 2023. And one of the visas on the list was the student subclass 500 visa. Previously, applicants were required to pay a fee of AU$650 to lodge their student visa applications. However, the fee will now sit at AU$715, representing an increase of $65. Now, many other visa subclasses will also be seeing an increase in the cost of VACs. Some of the other visa subclasses seeing increases include the visitor, which is the subclass 600 visa, which is seeing its application charge go from $150 to $190, as well as the working holiday / work and holiday visas, which are the subclasses 417 and 462 respectively. These visas previously cost applicants $510 to apply for, but will now cost $640 to apply for. Another important update that we need to talk about relates to post-study work rights. Earlier this year, the Australian government announced an extension to post-study work rights set to come into effect on the 1st of July, 2023. And the best part? This extension targets international students who have graduated with eligible qualifications that help fill Australia's workforce shortages. So let's break it down qualification by qualification so that you can know exactly what to expect depending on your degree type. If you're a bachelor's degree graduate, your post-study work rights will now be extended from 2 years to 4 years. For master's degree graduates, it's going from 3 years to 5 years. And for doctoral graduates, it's an extension from 4 years to 6 years. So while all of that is good and fine for you to know, what does it actually mean for you? If you're an international student holding or planning to apply for a temporary graduate subclass 485 visa, and your qualification is on the approved list, then you automatically get the extension. And if you're studying, living, and working in regional areas, you could get even more time, possibly an additional 1 to 2 years. But let's say that you're currently on a temporary graduate visa and it expires before the 1st of July. There's no need to worry in this case because you'll still be covered. However, in this circumstance, you'll simply be granted a different type of visa. In this case, you'll be granted a 2-year temporary activity, subclass 408, Australian government endorsed events visa, under the COVID-19 pandemic event. So this is the visa that you will be granted instead of another 485 visa. Now, we know it's a little bit of a mouthful, it's a little bit hard to remember and to retain, but trust us when we say this visa will be your best friend if you're hoping to stay longer in Australia. Now, it's very, very important to remember that these extensions only apply to the post-study work stream of the 485 visa, not to the graduate work stream. And again, you must hold an eligible qualification in an eligible industry in order to be eligible for the extension. To find out whether your qualification is eligible, we recommend heading over to the Department of Education website and taking a look at the full indicative list of eligible qualifications. Next on the list, we have more opportunities for Indian students and professionals in Australia. So, fantastic news for Indian students and young professionals in Australia, or those who are considering coming over in the near future. Our Prime Ministers, so Prime Minister Albanese and Prime Minister Modi, have been working behind the scenes to create an abundance of new exciting opportunities for you. And many of these opportunities are available as of July 1st, 2023. One of the highlights of this strengthened relationship is the introduction of the Mobility Arrangement for Talented Early Professionals Scheme, also known more simply as the MATES program. This innovative program is opening up 3,000 spots every single year, allowing young Indian professionals to experience working and living in Australia for up to 2 years. And the best part is that no visa sponsorship or employer sponsorship is needed. The agreement is also bringing forward some really positive changes for students and soon-to-be graduates in Australia. Starting from the 1st of July, 2023, Indian graduates from Australian tertiary institutions can apply to work in Australia for up to 8 years. So, whether you're currently studying here or you're planning to, these latest developments are opening doors for more choices, more opportunities, and a very, very promising future here in Australia. Finally, let's talk about some very important changes to Australia's skilled migration program. If you're nearing the end of your studies, then you may be exploring your options within Australia's skilled migration program. And if that's the case, then listen up, because the program is seeing some very significant changes as of July 1st, 2023. For one, the Albanese government has announced a major increase in the temporary skilled migration income threshold, which is also known by the acronym TSMIT. This is the minimum salary that a skilled visa applicant must earn to be eligible for employer sponsorship. Starting from the 1st of July, the TSMIT will rise from $53,900 to $70,000. This significant update is the first of its kind in a decade, reflecting changes that we've seen in wage growth over the last 10 years in Australia. This update comes in response to an independent review of the migration system, which found that roughly 90% of full-time jobs in Australia were paying above that threshold of $53,900. As a result, the government felt that the increase was essential to ensure the efficacy of the skilled migration system. But there's more good news. Temporary skilled workers are also set to get a more direct pathway to permanent residency. According to SBS News, the government's goal is to provide all skilled temporary workers with the opportunity to apply for permanent residency by the end of 2023. Now, we've covered a lot of topics today, and by now you should hopefully have a better idea of what to expect from July 1st onward. But where can you go if you want to learn more or if you have questions about your specific circumstances? You can stay updated on visas and migration changes via the Department of Home Affairs. For more information on your working rights, including working hour limits and the minimum wage, your go-to resource is going to be the Fair Work Ombudsman, which is also known as the FWO. And of course, don't forget to keep your eyes peeled to the Insider Guide's website as well as our socials. Now, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comment section what other videos you'd like to see from us. And in the meantime, thank you so much for joining us today, and we'll see you very soon.